The electricity is transmitted either by overhead transmission lines or by underground transmission lines. Overhead transmission lines are exposed to nature and vulnerable to severe weather such as lightning, storms, hurricanes, etc. Even though underground transmission lines are somewhat immune to weather-related failures, any damage is difficult to pinpoint and repair. It may take a couple of weeks to several months to repair. Damage to overhead lines are easily located and typically takes several hours or days to repair. These two transmission systems have their own advantages and disadvantages. I'm not going to talk about that in this video. Instead, I'm going to answer an interesting question. We know that transmission line is nothing but a conductor. Can we use the same conductor line for overhead and underground transmission system? The answer is no. This is mainly due to two reasons. To know more about this, continue watching. Hi, I'm Vanilla and you're watching The Learning Curve. We are all familiar with the electrical wires that we use in our households. You might have noticed that these wires are wrapped with insulation. But if you consider the overhead transmission lines, they are not wrapped with insulation. Here, the surrounding air acts as insulation. Can you guess what happens when you bury the same bare conductor as an underground transmission line? When we bury a bare conductor, it will be surrounded by soil. Soil is not an insulator. It conducts electricity. So, transmitted electricity will be discharged into the ground. We don't want that to happen. Therefore, instead of bare conductors, underground cables are wrapped in layers of insulating materials. This is the first reason. Now, let's move on to the next reason. When the current flows through a conductor, some power is dissipated as heat. This is due to I square R losses. The overhead transmission line is surrounded by air. This moving air helps the conductor to transfer the heat. In case of underground transmission lines, the layers of insulating materials trap the heat inside the conductor. This is not good for our conductor. In order to avoid this, we have to reduce the heat dissipation. In other words, we have to reduce the I square R losses. To achieve this, we have to reduce the resistance of the conductor. We know that R is equal to rho L by A. This means to reduce the resistance, we have to increase the area of cross-section of the conductor. Therefore, for the same current rating, the underground cables require larger conductors to prevent overheating. This means underground transmission lines should be thicker than the overhead transmission lines. So, we cannot use the same line for both. That's all for today. Bye. See you in my next video.